is more focused on dialogue with the buyers, who is more focused on intangibles, who is more focused on his consumers than looking to tap the new buyers. I am with Ravi Menon, chairman of SOBHA Limited, a man known to be very silent, but behind his silent smile, probably there is a confidence that he has delivered in a business like real estate, housing in particular, in a market where the news has always been about consumer backlash, the news has always been about non-delivery. This is one brand which has consistently performed, and it has a track record that very few can match, even in global context. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you so much.
So, in real estate business, everybody has thought about creating a brand and then started focusing on the product. Your journey has been quite reverse process. Has it been by default, or you started thinking on those lines much before you came into the business?
Right. So I think just to go back a little bit about SOBHA, the way we started. So my father established this business 25 years ago in India with a track record of having done excellent work in the Middle East, where he began his business life. So even then, and even today, I think the product has always been like the first priority for all of us. So when I look at the brand creation, I think that's only happened because of our ability to create, you know, products that have been comparable to the best across the world, impeccable quality, delivered within the timelines. I think all these factors have contributed to be able to create a brand. So I think it's always been the product first, and over a period of time of repeatedly doing the same practice, I think the brand gets established.
Most of the Indian developers have tried to go abroad, create an international brand. Your process has been reverse journey, a proven track record in a market like Dubai. But there is a general perception among the NRIs that your brand philosophy has not been talked about. It has been seen as a brand which does not talk about itself. How do you look at it? Do you want to change this perception now?
Absolutely. I think it's important for us to reach all areas as far as the brand is concerned. We believe that there is a large market sitting out there with the NRIs. We currently see about 25-30% from NRIs buying into property in India. So there is definitely a requirement for SOBHA to be present in their minds. And today, of course, marketing has become more so a digital, a larger play is on digital. In the case of SOBHA also, 60-70% sometimes our spends are on digital. And this, we believe, is one way to reach out to that NRI population. In addition to this, we also have offices, because Middle East is a big market for us, having an office in Dubai, and in the East we have an office in Singapore. So both these offices, again, further help us to reach out to this NRI population to bring more awareness as far as the brand is concerned. We're also putting more information out there on our website, which also, there's a lot of focus on creating the right content. So all this, I think, sometimes sitting far away, you need to know what you're buying into, especially when it comes to property. So we're trying a lot, ourselves to create that sort of content, which is easily available and accessible to the NRIs. And of course, when it comes to property buying, they always would want to come in and see the site. So during the vacations, or they have someone over here in India who usually comes and looks at the property on behalf of them. That's another way that we engage with the NRIs during their visits when they come to India. But at the same time, I think there is still, yes, a lot of room to do much more. And our online expo is one such event which we're launching for the first time to reach out to the same audience.
Before I come to this concept of online expo, I have in my mind that SOBHA has been ranked number one by Tractor Realty for 5 consecutive years. There are players, lesser known brands, who are more bullish on the NRI market. Do you ever feel the heat of competition over there?
I think competition is always there. India, of course, is a very large market, and there are so many players. Every day you have new people coming into the field. I think the field is now, it's a level playing field with all the regulatory changes that have been done by the government. So I think it's a very fair and level playing field. Within this playing field, we believe that SOBHA also has a big role to play. We're very confident because, one, we have complete confidence on the product. The quality is unquestionably, we're giving it our best. And it doesn't stop. It's a continuous journey. You know, improving is a daily discussion within our company. So we also look at inform the customer better. So when it comes to competition, of course, marketing is a big way which you can reach out and communicate to the audience. So product being good, at the same time you have to parallelly also reach out to the right audience, who is your targeted customer. So we're using all forms of, you know, digital, traditional means to reach out to this audience within India as well as outside.
What made you think of an online expo? Online expo has been quite successful for certain companies, and it has not worked so well for some other companies. So what kind of online expo you are planning, and how do you want to take it forward to succeed?
Sure. So basically, the concept of the online expo began with you know, an internal deliberation of how we can reach out to a larger population. And today in India, SOBHA has a presence across 10 cities. We have more than 25 projects currently on offer across these cities. So I think the reach has given us a tag of a so-called pan-India player. Even though we would like to, of course, mature in the newer cities like we have in our core city, which is Bangalore, we believe there's so much of potential in these newer cities. As far as the expo is concerned, we have done the more traditional format of an expo, which is a physical expo, which is at a single location. And we invite all our regions and all the projects within those regions to be displayed within this physical format. Physical expos are good. Of course, it draws the biggest crowd in the city that it is being held. Traveling, as you know, is always a difficult thing, especially in a city like Bangalore, where people have to move from one side to the other side. It takes a lot of time. And I think there are limitations as far as the reach is concerned. Then the discussion around how do we sort of enhance this whole, you know, sort of reach. And today, like I said earlier, the digital is a big game that is being played by everyone across in today's world, in marketing world. So we believe that there's a place for an online expo, especially for a player like SOBHA, which has a large portfolio of projects to offer across the country. So we believe the reach could be not just within the Indian you know, cities, but also outside our Indian territory. So that is something that we believe will bring in a lot of traffic, and at the same time be able to give them the whole platform and show them what's behind SOBHA. Also, sometimes it's important to understand what's behind the scenes and what goes into the product. A lot of people do not have that exposure, and we believe that if you put the right content out there, it becomes easily accessible to the customer, and probably helps them make the decision quicker.
Beyond cutting down the traffic hassles, what are the tangibles and intangibles that you have in mind with this online expo?
From a tangible perspective, of course, we believe that it is going to generate a large number of leads, you know, which would definitely help us to be able to close a large number of sales. As far as intangible is concerned, like you had said earlier, the exposure to the brand is very important. A lot of people in cities that we have smaller presence in, even though we may have a presence with a project or two projects, I think it's important for you know, people in that city also to understand that there is a larger game that is being played by SOBHA across the country. So the exposure will definitely help us to communicate what goes behind the brand. There will be a sense of appreciation because there's a lot of work that we have done as an organization. We are a completely backward integrated company where we do everything from design to construction ourselves. And I think this aspect is also sometimes very important for customers to understand when they have to make that final decision as to why this company is actually structured this way. And the only reason we do this is because we believe that the end product has to have the the quality that we believe that we have to deliver ourselves rather than depend on someone else to do it for us. So I think all these messages get communicated effectively, and probably this would be the more intangible side where there would be a rub-off effect. It would play in the minds of customers that, look, the brand is quite serious about the way that it goes about delivery. And maybe not immediately, but maybe they talk to friends, they talk to family, and there is a rub-off effect that happens when they become more aware of the brand. And at some point of time when they think about property purchase, they would say definitely SOBHA would be one of the brands that they would consider at that point in time.
SOBHA is known to have a two-way dialogue process with the existing buyers. Not many companies are focused on the existing buyers. Everybody is looking to tap new buyers. You have a SOBHA Connect program through which you connect with your existing buyers. Yes. Are you trying to open a window of dialogue with this online expo as well?
Absolutely. Like you mentioned about the SOBHA Connect program, it's a very important initiative that the organization has taken to go back to completed projects. I don't know how many developers actually do that. We have completed several properties over the last 25 years across multiple cities. So it's an initiative that sort of goes back and talks to customers who have actually lived and experienced the property. And I think their views actually are quite important because it helps us to improve considerably. So I keep, it's like a listening exercise that we continuously do. And the feedback that we receive from these customers goes back into our design teams, goes back to our project delivery teams. So all this is quite important as far as we are concerned because it helps us to evolve faster, learning through a very, very authentic source. And similarly, the online channel will also be very much similar to this. It gives us the reach probably much quicker. So we believe that the online expo, we are planning to put these customer testimonials that we have done from the Connect program on the online expo, that people also understand what customers are actually saying, people who are actually lived and experiencing the product, which I think is the biggest branding anyone can ask for. If people are satisfied with the quality over a period of time and they vouch for the product as far as the even the maintenance, for instance, all those little points really matter when you actually come in and stay at the property. So I think all these testimonials we'll be putting up on the online platform. So like I said earlier, it's going to be a very content-rich exercise. We're trying to put as much of information out there so that the decision for the customer becomes easier.
Content rich is something which is the intangible part of an expo.
Right.
But when it comes to an average prospective home buyer, all that he is looking for is incentive. So how are you planning to incentivize the prospective buyers through this expo?
Right. I think for us, the largest part is, of course, delivering a very high quality product and within the timelines that we have promised. And I think in my mind, that is the biggest incentive that the customer also should be actually seeing. But of course, in addition to it, we have certain offers which are currently on for this season, which is the winter season of the online expo. And we plan on continuing this, doing it four times a year. So it's going to be an exercise that we think we can repeat. So I believe that customers will definitely understand that this brand is quite serious about the way that it goes about this business. And in this industry, I think customers will be able to clearly differentiate and understand that SOBHA stands apart as far as delivery and product is concerned. I think all this will come out from this online expo exercise, and I think that's the biggest incentive for them.
So this has been a very candid Ravi Menon, the man who is more focused on dialogue with the buyers, who is more focused on intangibles, who is more focused on his consumers than looking to tap the new buyers. Online expo in this part of the world has gone wrong many times, and the reason why it has gone wrong is because the developers have focused on push marketing, something that turns off the consumers. Here, the leading brand of Indian real estate is not looking to tap the new buyers alone. They are looking to tap new buyers, but at the same time, they don't want to cut off with the existing buyers who have been their best brand ambassadors. With this, This is Ravi Sinha signing off.